What's going on, everybody? It's your bro here. Hope you're doing well. And in this video, I'm going to teach you guys all about radio buttons in Java. So sit back, relax, and enjoy the show.
If you find this video helpful, please remember to like, comment, and subscribe. Your support will help keep this channel running.
Well, howdy, y'all. We're going to be talking about radio buttons in this video. So the definition of JRadioButtons is that these are one or more buttons in a grouping in which only one may be selected per group. So let me give you a demonstration of my setup before we actually get into radio buttons. I have two classes, one just called main, it contains my main method, and an instance of my other class, MyFrame. So MyFrame extends JFrame, it behaves exactly like a JFrame, it also implements an action listener. And within this constructor, I just have this.setDefaultCloseOperation, JFrame exit on close. I'm using a new flow layout, this.pack, and this.setVisible set to true. And then I also have an action performed method within here. So let's get started by making some JRadioButtons. Here's a scenario for this example. Let's say that I'm buying you lunch because I'm such a nice guy, but you can only pick one item from the menu. You can pick either a slice of pizza, a hamburger, or a hot dog. So we're going to create three radio buttons, and you can select one of those choices, and we're going to place all of these within one grouping. So let's begin by creating a radio button for pizza. So to create a radio button, it is J radio button, and we'll call this radio button the pizza button. J radio button pizza button equals new J radio button. All right, let's do the same thing for a hamburger button and a hot dog button. So J radio button, this will be our hamburger button, and then a hot dog button. So we can set some text. We can either use the set text method, or we can just pass in a string within the constructor. So just for convenience, I'm going to pass in pizza, then hamburger, then hot dog. And then we need to add these buttons to the frame. So this.add, let's add our pizza button first, followed by hamburger and then hot dog. And this is what we should have. All right, we have pizza, hamburger, and hot dog. But wait a second, we've been bamboozled. We can select all of these items if we wanted. So we can actually limit the choice selection to only one item, but we have to put all of these radio buttons within the same grouping because right now we can select all of these and I promised you only one thing for lunch today. So we need to place these within a button group. So let's place this here. We're going to create a new button group and we'll just call this group equals new button group. And then we need to add these radio buttons to this group. We can do that by typing in the name of the group, dot add, and what are we adding? All of these buttons. So let's add the pizza button, followed by the hamburger button. So group dot add hamburger button, and then the hot dog button. And now we can only select one item. One thing you should know, every time that you select one of these choices, it's actually triggering an event, and we can use our action performed method to detect which button was selected. So within our action performed method, we can place a simple if statement. If e.getSource is equal to, let's begin with our pizza button. If somebody selects the pizza button, then they get pizza. So let's do a system.out.println. You ordered pizza. But notice, this action performed method does not recognize our pizza button. That's because we declared our pizza button within the constructor of our MyFrame class. So this is a local component. We need to turn this global. So we can do that by just declaring this outside of our constructor. Since we've declared this pizza button outside of the constructor, this action performed method does recognize it now. However, we want to get rid of this portion where we declare this pizza button twice, but we do want to finish instantiating this, and we should do the same thing for our hamburger button as well as our hot dog button. So we're going to declare these, but not yet instantiate them until we're within our constructor. So hamburger button equals new JRadio button, and then we want to declare the hot dog button outside of the constructor, and then instantiate it within the constructor. So then the action performed method can actually recognize all of these components. So if e.getSource is equal to the pizza button, we'll print you ordered pizza. Then we'll do the same thing for our hamburger button and our hot dog button. And let's just use an else if statement to keep this simple. There's more sophisticated ways of doing this, but we're still noobs, so it's okay if we do if statements. So if e.getSource is equal to the hamburger button, I don't feel like typing all of this, so I'm going to paste it. Then we will just system.out.println, you ordered a hamburger. And then else if e.getSource is equal to our hot dog button. System.out.println, you ordered a hot dog. And let's run this. Here we have our pizza button, hamburger button, and our hot dog button. But wait a second, we've been bamboozled again, because when we select these, it's not printing out our message. Well, that's because we still need to add an action listener to each of these buttons. So let's work on that next. I'll just add them here. So let's select each of these buttons. So we have our pizza button, and we need to add an action listener. So pizzaButton.addActionListener. Now, since we're implementing an action listener interface, we can simply just pass in this. And then let's do the same thing for our hamburger button and our hot dog button. Now these radio buttons will be able to listen for events. And when we click on one of our radio buttons, we will order our selected item. You ordered a pizza, you ordered a hamburger, and you ordered a hot dog. This is entirely optional, but you can actually change the icons that you're using for these radio buttons. So within my project folder, I have three images that I want to use: an emoji of a slice of pizza, a hot dog, and a hamburger. So I'm going to create some image icons out of these, and we're going to set the icon for each of these radio buttons to that image. So if you have a few in mind, let's begin. So let's create a few image icons. So for my first icon, this will be my pizza icon. Then I'll do the same thing for hamburger and hot dog. And then within the constructor, I'll finish instantiating this. So pizza icon equals new image icon, and I'm going to list the file path of where this is located. Since this is within my same project folder, I can just simply list the file name. So my first image is pizza.png. And then hamburger, then hot dog. Alright, so I have all of my image icons set up. Now to add an icon to a button, there is a function to do so. I'll add them here. So type in the name of the button. There it is, pizza button. Dot, you can either set icon or set selected icon. I'm just going to use set icon and list the icon that you want to use. I want to use my pizza icon. So I'll put that here, and then let's do the same for the other buttons. So hamburger button dot set icon, hamburger icon. And then lastly, hot dog. And now those circles are going to be replaced with our images, and they work just the same. So we have a slice of pizza, a hamburger, and a hot dog. All right, so that's the basics of creating radio buttons in Java. If you want a copy of all this code, I'll post all of this in the comments down below. But yeah, that's the basics of creating radio buttons in Java.
Hey you. Yeah, I'm talking to you. If you learn something new, then you can help me help you in 3 easy steps by smashing that like button, drop a comment down below, and subscribe if you'd like to become a fellow bro.